Hey YouTube, Cine Steve back with another video. Let you know what I've been picking up. So nice to be back in the game room again. I've had it all done out, it's looking brilliant, but I didn't want to put out a sort of a game room tour or an update until I've got the pickups out of the way, because obviously I've got the pickups scattered around all over the place. I just figured get the pickups out of the way and then show you what I've done with the place. I mean, from this end, doesn't look too much different. I've got the shelves up and around again and the cab's back in its place. I think where I'd literally had it how I wanted it before, actually when I sort of extended out that way, brought everything back in, nothing really changed that much. So now happy with the setup and it is looking great, but I'll show that in another vid. I just thought I'd get a vid, I'd say, the pickups and a bit of chat about Revival. Obviously that's a couple of weeks ago now. But it was a great event. I got a couple of pickups from there. A couple of shout outs go to a few people I saw there. Done me some favours. And really, it was just such a top event. There were so many guys there. And seeing people like Retro Dave playing games with Dave, it's such a great laugh, such a brilliant laugh. I mean, that's what I quite like, seeing Dave there actually, because he really gets you playing games rather than just sort of sitting around talking about them all day. He really gets involved and we get a bit of friendly banter, a bit of competition going, and yeah, it was such a great laugh. Well happy playing some games there for a change really, rather than, let's say, just sitting around talking about them. But moving on to the pickups. And my first shout out goes to Tooty. I'll go with the biggest one first. Basically, I bought a game off eBay. Going back, this was months going back. Bought Super Frog for the Amiga. Now, I've got this as part of a compilation, the Team 17 compilation, but I wanted the big box. And was checking eBay, had it in my eBay search, and this one finally came up because I wanted it in obviously nice condition. And it was a really nice minty copy of Super Frog. Now, I remember I shot the guy an offer. It was in auction, like 99p start, whatever, and I sort of said, look, you take 25 quid posted. And he was like, to be honest, I don't really know what it's worth, so he's just gonna let the auction go, which I was like, yep, fair enough. But I mean, the amount of times you see things on eBay that you want and they just disappear. So I tend to be one of those sort of annoying guys that, yeah, puts a bid out there, and it's not necessarily to get it on the cheap, but more, if you really want something and it disappears, you're just annoyed about it. So yeah, I just shot him an offer, and he was really quick back to me, seemed like a nice fella, and I was like, yeah, no problem, I'll keep my eye on it. And luckily I won it in auction, and I believe I got it for, I think it was about £28 posted. And I think after that the guy was like, well, actually, yeah, I wasn't trying to mug him off. So he sent me a message back sort of saying, look, he's got a lot of other stuff. He's not a massive fan of posting stuff out, and he sent me loads of pictures on WhatsApp of this big bundle. And he lived in Coventry, and I say I was going back months, and I thought, well, Coventry is not a million miles away from Walsall, I'll pick it up on that date when I'm going up to Revival. Yeah, brilliant. And then realised I got my weeks modelled up, and weekend I planned to get it wasn't the week of Revival, it was the week after. And when I sort of told him my mistake, not long before Revival, he was like, I think he was in Wales that day with his family. So I was like, I'll try and work something out. So I got all the Tooty UK, old Toots, Stu, done me a massive favour. I got the guy to drop it off at his, because Tooty doesn't live far from Coventry, I know that was his hometown. So done me a massive favour and brought it down to Revival for me. So massive thanks to Toots, absolutely done me a massive favour, because I think I got a bit of a bargain with it. I'm not going to show you everything, but I got a CD32 all box complete, an Amiga 1200 box complete, and loads of games. And the main reason I wanted it was purely because of how mint the Super Frog was. Even though I had quite a few of the games I was getting, I thought, they're just going to be upgrades, even though my ones are not in bad condition. I just know, looking at the pictures, that they're going to be upgrades, and I can just sort of sell what I don't need, like the Amiga 1200 and the CD32. I don't really need that, so I won't show you those. I just don't need them. I've already got CD32 RGB modded, so I don't need that. And the 1200, I've got WHD load and an accelerator card. Just don't need those. So yeah, I gave them £500, all in. And in my opinion, I think I'll probably get that back with the 1200 and the CD32, because say some of the doubles where I got some of the games and when I bundle it all together, I reckon I'll get that £500 back, and then a lot of this stuff will actually be sort of for nothing. Basically, I think that's how a lot of collectors do it. We buy in bulk and sell the stuff you don't need, and then obviously you save yourself a lot of money. But yeah, enough chatting about it. I'm going to shoot through these games fairly quickly. I'd say it wasn't everything, so I've got a lot of loose discs and joysticks and whatnot, but I'll go through what I wanted it for and what I'm definitely keeping. So starting off, we've got Guardian on the CD32. I say I won't show you the insides, but they're really nice condition. All of these games, really nice nick. Sticking with the CD32, Worms. Again, this was another game I had, but not in this sort of condition. So really happy with that. This was the main reason I wanted it. I'm a massive Superfrog fan. And this is original CD32 big box Superfrog. And as I say, absolutely lovely minty condition. I mean, that's got to be worth sort of about £80 on its own. I mean, funnily enough, I saw that it was actually at Revival. And I think he had something like £60-70 on it. I don't know if he sold it, but I didn't think it was a bad price. And I think if I hadn't gone for this bundle, I would have definitely been trying to do a deal for it. So I've been after that for a while. We've got Big Box Super Stardust. A bit like an Asteroids remake clone. We've got ATR, sticking with the CD32. All Terrain Racing. Never played it, but I'll give it a go. Can't really go wrong with Team 17 games. We've got Alien Breed, Tower Assault. Don't know too much about it again. I think it's, is it like a 3D? Oh no. Still looks like a normal top-down Alien Breed. I'll give it a go. I was always quite like Alien Breed Special Edition. This is the 3D version. Mega CD 32 Alien Breed 3D. This one's got a bit of a crease in the box, but still not too bad. Then sticking with the CD32, there's these smaller ones as well. So we've got Out to Lunch. Again, don't know nothing about that game. Jet Strike, which looks a bit like a, I don't know if that's a simulator or an arcade game, but a flight action game, I'll give it a go, see what it's like. Simon the Sorcerer. I mean, those who knows their CD32 games, Amiga games in general, just they've really gone up in price. Bump and Burn. Again, don't know anything about that. So it looks like quite a cool racing game, actually. Give that a go. This I already had. Double Chaos Engine. Can't go wrong with Chaos Engine, great top-down shooter. And Roadkill, which apparently is a really good game. Now, I've got this for the CD32, but it was missing the front inlay. So I'm just bundle the doubles and sell with the box CD32. But yeah, I will give that a go, because I've heard good things about that. Then onto the floppy discs, we've got a Pidger. And again, like the conditions of these boxes, you can tell the guy really looked after his stuff. Ghouls and Ghosts. Not sure if that's any good for the Amiga. I tend to find them Capcom ports, like Midnight Resistance and a few others, they weren't very good, but I'll give it a check out. Zool 2, which again, this I already had, but it definitely didn't have, well, I know it hasn't, all the stickers, the poster, it's literally got everything in, completely untouched. So, really happy with the condition of these. We've got Zool, the original one. Again, I mean, it's got like the old receipts in a lot of these, poster, everything in there. Then we've got Mortal Kombat 2. Really hard to play the fighters with one button, but I remember Mortal Kombat, I remember buying this from Lakeside when I was young. I remember seeing it at the arcade and absolutely being blown away by it. And got my parents to buy it. This was sort of as all the ratings came out, all the age ratings, and I remember seeing that it was a 15, if you look at the little tag on there, but luckily my parents didn't see it. So yeah, got it home and absolutely blown away by it. Never seen anything like it, but I always remember it came with a stencil set, the Amiga version, so you push all that out and you, say, draw around it. Literally never been touched. Such good condition nowadays. Again, another double I had, but the box was absolutely smashed to pieces. Stardust. Another one that was on my radar to upgrade. Now, I don't know too much about this. I remember Uridium on the Commodore 64, but no idea about Uridium 2. I mean, it's got Renegade printed on it, so that's got to be a good sign, isn't it? Check that out. We've got Blastar. Again, don't know too much about it. It's probably one of the worst condition boxes I'm probably keeping. It's got a bit of a rip there. But other than that, it's in pretty good nick. Then down to the last four, All Team 17, Overdrive. Another one that was on my radar to pick up big box. I remember I had this back in the day again. It's a bit like Micro Machines. Quite a cool little top-down racer. Again, it's on that same compilation that's on with Super Frog. Got Alien Breed 2, Horror Continues. A really good series, actually. I'm gonna revisit these definitely. Body Blows. Don't know too much about this fight, to be honest. I do remember it back in the day, but I don't think I ever played it. As I say, fighters have never been amazing on the Amiga. Well, except IK Plus, I guess, but any of the newer ones. And then we've got Project X, which again, I've got this, but the box was really squashed. This one's in a lot better condition. Still a bit of a crease on it, but again, still a lot better than mine. Has the poster, original receipts. So that was the bundle from that guy that Tootie brought in for me. As I said, didn't meet the guy, I spoke to him quite a lot on the phone. I know obviously Tootie met him. Seemed like a lovely fella. So yeah, brilliant deal on that. What shall I move on to now? So I've got quite a few pickups. I'm gonna try and keep this video quite short. Let's go on to Revival. No, I'll tell you what, London Gaming Market, because that was probably a couple of months back. I only literally picked up two games from London Gaming Market, both Mega Drive. I think I got a steal with both of them. Hurricanes, no hang tab, but I can give it a bit of a box upgrade, all complete. £10 that cost me, Hurricanes. I mean, that's easily a 20-25 quid game, so a bit of a bargain with that. And then the other one Super Baseball 2020. This doesn't have the manual, which is probably going to be quite hard to source, but it was literally, the prices on there, £8. That's the top price for that game, but yeah, shame it doesn't have the manual, but maybe might pick one up. I'll put it in my save list, but if eBay might shoot one. We'll see. Then, keeping with the London gaming market, I was talking to my good friend Roger Cantor, who supplies a few cabs for Revival. If you ever played Ice Cold Beer, that was Roger's. Really, really nice fella. He's got quite a few cabs. I've just known him from like UK VAC and seen him at meets. Yeah, top guy. Loves his PC Engine stuff, his 16-bit stuff, like especially like imported gear. And I was walking around the London gaming market with him, and we saw this PC Engine with the Super SD system on the back. Now, I'd sort of heard of it, but didn't know anything about it. I've never owned a PC Engine, but after looking at that, I was thinking, I think that's definitely a system I want to get involved in. You've got a lot of shoot 'em ups on there. And literally later that week, I ordered the Super SD System 3. I know it's where's it come from? I think it came from Spain, so I knew it was going to take quite a long time to sort of ship and come to me. So I thought I'd just buy it, like just order it, and then keep on the lookout for a PC Engine. I won't show you the box. What I'm going to do, I think I'll do like a first thoughts of this, because I've got it all set up, so the box is empty anyway. So I won't show you the actual unit. But then I think it was about 3 weeks after, because it took about 5 weeks to get to me, but about, it must have been about 3 or 4 weeks after ordering that, I saw a PC Engine on UK VAC, somebody selling it, Core Graphics. And this is what I picked up. So we've got a new system set up in the game room. And this is in lovely condition, really, this Core Graphics. It's literally got everything with it, all the baggies, all the cable. I say that nothing's in there because it's all set up now. I've left all the cables in there because I'm using a UK power supply and Mega Drive 2 RGB cable, because that's what this Super SD system is compatible with. You just buy the Mega Drive 2 RGB cable, so you've got RGB straight out of this unit. And obviously an SD card, put that in there full with HuCard game images. And you can also put CD images on there. But as I say, I'll do a separate video on that because I'm really, really impressed with that. But then moving on to Revival again, sticking with the PC Engine. 16-bit Griffo. I took a PC into him. It was Beeps, Brian. You probably know Beeps from his mods and whatnot on YouTube. He does a lot of mods. Lovely guy. Again, he's another guy I've known quite a long time. He fixed Griffo's PC for him, and I'd never met Griffo before. I spoke to him a few times on YouTube and whatnot, and he needed his PC dropped off to him at Revival, because apparently Beeps had posted it before and it had been damaged. So, and Beeps' family doesn't live too far from me, so he dropped it here, which I say it wasn't an issue, like wasn't any problems. And I took it to Revival and gave it to Griffo, and he gave me this, which I say I'm blown away by, really. My first PC Engine game, a physical game. He'd obviously seen my videos before. I must have mentioned that I was after a PC Engine. And I just thought it was really nice of him. I mean, obviously I'm a massive Street Fighter 2 fan. And literally can't believe actually how good this is. I wouldn't mind getting a 6-button pad now, really, because you're sort of pressing start to toggle between kicks and punches. It's a little bit like playing the Mega Drive version with a 3-button pad. But no, massive thanks for that. It's like, really didn't have to do that. It wasn't a problem bringing it, so that will stay obviously nicely in the collection. That was a really, really nice gesture. Sticking with Revival, I picked up a few framed pictures from Matt Soulfunk Retro. I know that Nintendo Alex He's when he done his game room tour, he got a few of these off of him, and they are stunning. I mean, this is obviously Chess HQ, one of my favourite arcade games that I used to have. And obviously, with now the game room being done, I do want to get some art back up. So you've got the Chess HQ and another one of my favourite arcade games, Outrun. But yeah, really nice frames. The prints are really nice. He does a lot of like longer frame prints of like Street Fighter and Streets of Rage. So no, really cool, really happy with those. Check him out, as I say, Soulfunk Retro. He's got a shop on Facebook, and I believe he's got a YouTube channel as well, although I don't think he's as active as he used to be. So again, sticking with Revival pickups and Amiga as well. It might have been Sore Thumbs. I really can't remember the trader, but they had quite a few Amiga games there. And the prices were really good. I was talking to Big Mike, Without Further Ado Retro, when I finally got caught up with him. I know he was there quite early, and I was there at Revival really early. But I didn't actually catch up with him till probably 3-4 o'clock, I would have thought. So I know it was late in the day. And I said to him, I said, yeah, you wanna check those Amiga games out, because there are a few good prices there. And I mean, I was there early. I mean, I think I got in about 8:30. Sort of not pretended I was helping out, but I was meeting Roger in there and Alex. And I mean, I'd already had a ticket bought for me, and I didn't even have to in the end. I just walked in, and then later that day, before they was opening, they handed all the bands out, the wristbands. But as I say, I like to support it anyway. Craig does a great job, so yeah, I'm not worried about paying entry. But so I've got a few Psygnosis Amiga games. Don't know anything about this one, Chrono Quest 2. I've always liked the artwork on Psygnosis games. I know Mr. Bads Retro Games, Paul, he loves his Psygnosis games. He's got an amazing Psygnosis or Amiga collection, well, just gaming collection in general. He'll probably know more about this than I do, but I mean, 15 quid, not sure if that's a good price or not really with this, but looking at the other two Psygnosis games, which I know are decent prices, I think that's probably spot on. And I don't actually think I paid that. I think I actually got this for like 12 quid. I know I got like 3 quid off. I'm sure it was 3 quid off. But yeah, all in nice condition, all complete. And then I've got three games here. What did I do? I know I bought two and then went back for the other one. So the other one was Armageddon, which I believe I did pay full price for. In fact, I know what I did, and I'll tell you what I did when I show you that last one. But yeah, £8 Armageddon. Again, don't know anything about it. It probably hasn't aged very well, looking at the back screenshots. But 8 quid for a Psygnosis game in good nick. That cannot be bad. So this was the one that really caught my eye, and it is Leander. Now, I bought this earlier this year, I believe, for £25, and even that was a pretty good price, but it was quite squashed, the front of the box. And I didn't actually notice that. I bought it in a bundle with other games, and he bundled them all together and sent them to me. And then when Leander came, I was really disappointed with the condition, but looking back at the ad, it was my own fault for not really looking properly. But yeah, £10 Leander. I mean, that's got to be a £40 game all day, and it's in lovely condition, all complete. So that's obviously upgraded mine. And what I ended up doing, I believe I gave £20 for this and Chrono Quest 2, so that worked out £10 each, and then didn't even argue with the Armageddon price. So I thought that was a really, that was a steal, an absolute steal, that game. So yeah, that was all I got from Revive. I got those three Amiga games and the art, and obviously the big pickup from Tootie. So moving on to eBay, another Psygnosis game, well, Cyclaps, so pre-Psygnosis, Menace. And this game has been on my radar for a long time now, and I've just been waiting for a nice one to come up with the right price. And believe this was £26, which again, I'm sure it's about a £35-40 game, maybe a little bit more. Again, it's all complete, all in nice condition. So yeah, I've been really lucky with bargains this year, really, I think. I've paid full price on a few games, and I know I've paid some scalper prices on the next item I'm going to show you. Well, other items from the same seller. But another massive thanks goes out to Big Mike, Without Further Ado Retro, for sorting me out this. It's the limited edition Space Harrier 2 from Datadiscs vinyl soundtrack. And basically, when this was being released for pre-order, basically they send you an email and you can log in with a password and order it. And I completely forgot to set an alarm up. I was actually at Alex's, Nintendo Alex Arcade. I was at his house on a meet, and it was me and Retro Dave playing Sheriff. And I remember looking at my phone thinking, I can't believe it, like, literally, what have I done? I've completely forgot about it. Went on the website, I think this was about 3 o'clock, so about 3 hours after it came on sale. And yeah, sold out. I was like, brilliant. And then Mike, in fact, I think it was Big Mike that actually texted me at the time. He texted me sort of showing off, saying he'd pre-ordered two of them. And I was like, oh, brilliant. I've completely forgot. And being the gent that Big Mike is, he's given me that for face value. So, brilliant. Absolutely over the moon with it. And I've listened to it. I don't keep them sealed. I do listen to them. Lovely, great music. You can't go wrong with a bit of Sega music. So yeah, again, massive thanks for that, Mike. I'll owe you a beer for that one. So on to eBay. Let's go with these ones. eBay. I've got a bit of a Mega Drive bundle. I know it was some girl on there that she'd bundled a few games together and then put some separately, and it was one in a bundle that caught my eye, and I asked if she would if we could do our own sort of bundle, if she sort of takes them off eBay. What I do now, if I want to do something like that, because I know if you put your phone number in or your email address or anything like that, or mention anything about dealing outside eBay straight on, she'd give me a warning. So what I end up doing is splitting my phone number up and asking for pictures, and then as soon as they send them, I'm like, yeah, let's do a deal. And I've got all of these four games for, it was £45 delivered, and all complete, all in pretty good nick, all but one of them. But I've done an inlay swap with one of them, which I was quite lucky with CEX. I think we'll do it. I won't get into it, but CEX sorted me out with a new inlay. First game being Sonic Compilation, which is obviously Sonic 1, Sonic 2, Mean Bean Machine. I've got them all separate, but I didn't have that game and it caught me eye. It was in good condition. This game was on my little list of games to get. Dynamite Duke. Again, all hang tabs, all complete. Pretty nice nick. And then we've got Buster's Hidden Treasure, Tiny Toons. Don't know much about this. I know it's not a particularly expensive game, but it's a Konami game, so usually can't go wrong with Konami. But this was the game that really caught my eye. I know it's quite sought after. Still not really sure of the pronunciation. Is it Soleil? Soleil? Not really sure. I know it's like a bit of a Zelda clone for the Mega Drive. But what I didn't notice I wouldn't have noticed it in the pictures, but the actual inlay was pretty much disintegrated. I've never seen an inlay like it. I took it out to check the inlay, and it literally wanted to fall apart into like a million pieces. So I just closed it back up, and just ordered one from CEX and swapped it. Put that around the right way, because I know Tootie's Asperger's goes crazy. All complete, manuals all in nice nick. So yeah, that was a nice little eBay purchase. I'm pretty sure that Soleil goes for about £40 on its own again. Sticking with eBay and something a bit different. got CT Special Forces on the original PlayStation. I saw this on a YouTube video, and it's a bit of a Metal Slug clone, and it plays really well. It's a little bit more sluggish than Metal Slug. Doesn't have the slowdown that Metal Slug has, and I played it for about, I put about 20-25 minutes into it. Yeah, seems like a really fun game. It probably needs a new case, but it's all there. It's all nice. Everything's in there. Look, it was really well packaged with bubble wrap and whatnot. And the disc isn't in there because it's in my PlayStation. But yeah, all the manuals all there, all nice. So yeah, I definitely recommend it. It was only a cheap game. It's only about £7-8 delivered, something like that. So I think that is all my eBay stuff. So let's go on to the Facebook groups. In fact, no, I'm not done with eBay. Let's stick with eBay. Another game that's been on my radar, and it keeps going up in price. So I pulled the trigger on it at 45, which I think's a little bit. I think it is going right, basically, and that's Sparkster, the sequel to Rocket Knight Adventures. Again, all complete. Manuals seen better days, but it's there. A bit dog-eared, but everything else is in really nice nick. So yeah, 45 on that, I believe. And then this was an absolute steal. International Sensible Soccer. This is the rarer Sensible Soccer on the Mega Drive. In absolutely lovely condition. All complete. I mean, the cart's got a little bit of wear to it. But other than that, it's all there, all really nice. Now, the guy advertised it as being sort of broken, question mark. He was a bit worried about the sound on it, like the noise of the crowd. But I've looked at a lot of YouTube videos, and I think it's just, well, I know it is. It's just how the sound is. I've put it on I tried it on a flash cart and was comparing it. So yeah, 20 quid delivered, which again I think is a steal. I'm sure that's, I know that that goes for a lot more than that. So yeah, that is my eBay. That's my eBay deals. Now moving on to Facebook groups. Not particularly bargains these. I think they're fair prices. I've got three games, three Mega Drive games. Quite a big hitter here. Castlevania. This, I've been after this for a long time. I've ordered a few off CEX that I've never been happy with, because I've only done it boxed, and I'm sure it's been around 70-80 quid. It's probably gone up since then. But this one came on eBay, on Facebook. I can't remember who was selling it, but it's really nice copy of it, and I'm sure it was either 80 or 90 quid. It was definitely under 90 quid, which, again, going rate, I think, but it's in nice nick, and again, I think it's just going to go up and up in price, like all Mega Drive games seem to be. Then we've got Cheeky Boys. Another game that's been on my list for a long, long time. Finally pulled the trigger on it again. Really nice nick, all complete. I mean, I will buy Mega Drive games now complete if I can. Very rare do I go for a game that's not complete on the Mega Drive. Unless it is a real steal. Again, I can't remember who I bought that from, but I'm sure it was only about £25, something like that. Again, pretty much going right. And then the last one being McDonald's Treasureland Adventures, which is a game made by Treasure. Apparently it's pretty good. And obviously being made by Treasure makes it sought after, all complete. And I believe this was 60 quid complete. Or was it cheaper than that? It was between 50 and 60. Delivered, which I remember seeing somebody else put it online, a trader put it online for something like 75 quid, and I've like 70, and he wouldn't take it, and I was like, oh, I'll leave it then, and then found it, yeah, cheaper. So happy with that one. Now I'm on to my last couple of bundles, and I've lied because I wasn't done with eBay, because I picked up some more Amiga CD 32 games, a little bundle. Now, I only really wanted this for one of the games. It was a bundle of three, and it worked out, I think it was about £62-63 delivered for these three games. Now, first one, Seek and Destroy, which, looking at, I haven't played it yet, but looking at the case, it looks like my sort of game, top-down shooter, so I'm definitely going to give that one a go. So happy with that. It's quite a bonus when you buy a bundle of games and then find a game and that you weren't really buying it for looking quite good. Then we've got Sports Football, which is definitely not my sort of thing. I've never been into American football, but as I say, it was in the bundle, so it'll probably just stay in the collection. Now, this is what I really wanted it for. Defender of the Crown 2. So really happy with this. All three in lovely condition, especially these sort of cardboard boxes that can really scuff up. It's all there, it's all complete. And I've actually been playing it. It's different. It's definitely different to the original Defender of the Crown. But yeah, really cool. I think that's been on my radar for a lot of years. I've been waiting a long time to get that at a decent price. And I think I've really done well getting it in that bundle for 60 odd quid. And then on to, right, PlayAsia. I ordered three games from PlayAsia and I haven't ordered new games for a while. But they sent me, I think it was like a promo deal, so I ended up getting, I think, like 15% off. All three of these are still sealed. I literally still haven't touched them because I haven't been back in the game room for very long. And the first one being Velocity on the Vita. I haven't got many Vita games, but this looked pretty cool. I think it's a bit like a twin stick sort of shooter. So I'll definitely give that a go. Looks really cool. This one I played on the Saturn, Game Paradise, another shooter, which it's a bit like a cute 'em up. It's a bit of a crazy one where it's got like candy cabs in the background and stuff like that. So really cool. Shoot 'em up, and obviously I love my candy cabs, so I had to have that one. And the Saturn version is silly money. And then Wild Guns Reloaded, which, as I say, I haven't played any of these, but I've heard really good things about this game. I will give that one a go soon. I know it's one of, again, Nintendo Alex's favourites. So, yeah, happy to add that, and I'll give that one a go. But, yeah, that is all my pickups. I know it's quite longer than what I wanted to be on this video, but as I say, it's when I've been out of the game room for about, 2 months now, I was still buying stuff thinking, oh, that'll look good in the game room, that'll look good, and I've just kept buying stuff, and it will slow down because I've got so much stuff that I really want to sort of play, do you know what I mean? I really want to sort of put time in and play, and I do want to make more time and make more videos. I might just sort of rip off Mr. Bad's channels because I think he's got it spot on with the way he does things. He'll do his pickups, he'll do his spotlight videos where he'll play a game with commentary and whatnot. He does some really good videos, really, really enjoy watching his videos. So I might start doing things like that and obviously doing little reviews of things I pick up and let you know what I think. But yeah, everyone that went Revival that I saw and spoke to, as I say, great, such a great day. I urge anyone that is just thinking about going to Revival, it's going to happen next year, and it was just such a good day. I spoke to a guy called Steve, Steve and his wife, because I picked a monitor up for him from a guy who lived just up the road, and he bought me a drink, which I was, again, didn't have to do. I was passing anyway, it's not an issue, but he was a really nice guy. He loves his sit down drives a lot of the sort of newer arcade cabs. And his missus, she was really nice as well. Seems to get involved in the gaming, although I think by the end of the day she was looking quite bored. but such a good day. So massive thanks to anyone that I saw there and come and chat to. And so really looking forward to next year's and a few of the other meets that's going on this year. I mean, my wife's like 8 months pregnant, so I can't make many events this year, but the UK VAC one I'll definitely be going to. That's in the middle of September. So, nice to meet you, YouTube. I'll catch up with you soon. Bye-bye.